Ladies and gentlemen, we do have a very special guest here, and our own Congressman Al Lawson. Congressman Harris, I'd like to welcome you to the 2018 version of the Capitol Tiger Bay Club, and we are honored to have as our first featured guest our speaker, our president of Florida State University. Thank you very much.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
I have a couple of announcements. First, our next program is scheduled for Wednesday, February 7th, and we will host the highly controversial, provocative, political operative, Roger Stone. We expect to have a pretty good-sized crowd, and the invitations are coming in at a pretty good pace, so we think it's going to be a catastrophically huge crowd.
It's my honor today to introduce the president of Florida State University, John Thrasher, legislative icon, lobbyist extraordinaire, Vietnam hero, known to be a man extraordinarily generous to his friends, and metaphysically terrifying to his enemies. Given his absence of academic experience, like many Florida State graduates, was pleased but somewhat puzzled when John agreed to place his name for consideration as president of the university. Many of us were thrilled to have someone of his caliber in Westcott, and no one could figure out why he wanted the job. Well, I'm here today to tell you the answer. He wanted the job because it's easy. A year or so ago, I had lunch with John's lovely wife, Jean, and when she left to go to the ladies' room, I happened to start rifling through her purse, and I noticed a book. It was a paperback, not a large book, and its cover was yellow and black. It was a Cliff Notes book on how to be a university president. Fortunately, Jean was gone long enough for me to thumb through it, and I was shocked. It was written like it could have been called The Lazy Man's Guide to Academic Leadership. And just about every page was thick with margin notes and heavy underlining. The most heavily notated chapter was titled, Use Your Vice Presidents Like Contract Killers. Think of them as hitmen hired to help build your personal empire. As Machiavelli said, it's better to be feared than loved. But regardless, you do what you have to do. Well, that caught my attention, because I used to be a vice president at FSU. As I read that text, I began to realize how brilliantly John Thrasher has manipulated people and opportunities to win praise and adulation for himself and an adoring public. I have a couple of examples. When John first took office, he called Vice President for Advancement Tom Jennings into his office and said, Tom, do you like your job? Tom, I want you to do something hugely dramatic. To kickstart this administration, you've got till noon tomorrow to get it done. And the very next day, the announcement was made of the $100 million gift to establish the nation's largest degree-granting school of entrepreneurship. Consequently, Tom still has both his knees. Then, John called Athletic Director Stan Wilcox into the office. Stan, I'm going to make you a vice president. That means you've got 24 hours to get the whole Jimbo Fisher thing off my desk. Nailed, and you'll be coaching roller derby at University of Phoenix. Sure enough, one day later, Jimbo is in Texas and Willie Taggart is giving press conferences in Tallahassee. Problem solved. Next, he met over lunch with new Vice President for Student Affairs, Amy Hecht. Amy, the fraternities and sororities are a pain in the butt. Get rid of them and make it look like you did it. By 3 p.m. the next afternoon, they were gone, and broad public support ensued. Well, John Thrasher doesn't really need Cliff Notes, and he isn't really mean, but he certainly has taken on a wide range of challenges as president. That's why I'm so pleased that he's taken time out of his schedule today to meet with us. May I present FSU President John Thrasher.
Lee and I started out on the Board of Trustees at FSU a few years ago, and she then went on to be vice president. She's done a great job. I love you and your family, Lee. Thank you so much for that. Really appreciate it. Thank you. Thanks for inviting me. Jeff, thank you for the invitation. And President of Student Body, thank you, sir. Some people think he hadn't grown out of that yet. I can tell you differently. He really has. He does a great job. And, you know, Jennifer Proffitt, I'm not going to say something about everybody, but Jennifer Proffitt, you know, she's used to be a union person. Now she's in management. So what do you think about that? I love it. Let me just say this. I've heard about your next month's speaker, Roger Stone, I think, right? And heard about, I think you had a couple of months ago, you had John Morgan. I just feel a little bit diminished by all that. I mean, I really do. I don't think I'll be quite as worthy as all those guys, but we'll see. But you got some good folks coming. I'm putting no doubt about it. First and foremost, before I go any further and get in any further trouble, which I will probably before this is over, I want to introduce the First Lady of Florida State University, my wife, Jean.
I'd like to say, you know, I've got two deans here. I'd like to say we have about 19, so two of 19 is not bad. I guess these two didn't have anything else to do today. So Dean Jim Clark for the social work is here, and Dean Aaron O'Connor from our College of Law is here. Thank you both for being here. And I got to serve with Big Al in the House of Representatives and in the Florida Senate. Proud of everything you're doing in Washington, Al. Thank you so much for your great leadership. Somebody mentioned Amy Heck. She is here, our Vice President of Student Affairs. She hadn't been doing much lately, but she took time out to be here today. I appreciate that. Another one of our vice presidents in the back and does a lot of work with our legislature and working with those folks. I hear they're in session, I heard. Anyway. You know, I heard also that the press kits for this week, Lucy, I know you know about those, you attend them. It's the one annual event every year that the press is intentionally funny.
Ron Sachs goes to them all the time. He's a prominent guy here and a good friend, but that's good. I didn't go this year. I probably wasn't in them, I'm sure, so I didn't go, Lucy, but I love the press kits. I think they're good. So, you know, and thank Micah, my God, you almost stood up. You did, almost, but not quite. You couldn't quite make it with the fight song. I appreciate it. I do appreciate the Gators. I really do. I love the Gators sometimes. And I'll tell you about a rumor in a minute. But, you know, I've been president now for about 3 years, a little over 3 years, actually. And many of the students who were freshmen are now, believe it or not, getting ready to graduate. People ask me from time to time if I miss the legislature, and I have to say no. I'm glad I'm doing what I'm doing. It's the best job I've ever had, and it'll be the last job I'll ever have. And it's been truly rewarding. In fact, this past year at FSU, I think we achieved some really unprecedented level of academic success, and I'm excited about the future. I think you heard it a while ago from Lee, but I think everybody's enthusiasm has been bolstered by our new head football coach, Willie Taggart. I like him. I like him a lot. I really do. And his love of FSU is frankly contagious, and, you know, actually hiring him was someone I used to know said kind of like a no-brainer, really. I mean, that's what Jimbo said. Come on. I know you still like Jimbo, but I mean, really, come on. Now, it's really good because I know when I visit football offices now over there at Moore Athletic Center, I no longer have the urge to keep my hand on my wallet. You know, it's... I think we need to give Coach Taggart a little time, frankly. You know, I keep talking to him as he get a lot of, you know, applause and all that kind of stuff. And, I said, and he keeps telling me, you know, I haven't won a game yet. I said, but you haven't lost one either. And I really believe he'll bring us a national championship. UCF national championship. Yeah. And let me, David and Reggie and my Gator friends, let me dispel a rumor, okay? I promise you. I've heard this rumor around town, and I want to dispel it right here. We are not dropping the University of Florida to improve our strength of schedule. I know you probably are thinking a little bit of that. That's a lot of big talk from someone who spent some Christmas holidays in Shreveport. But it was fun. Gene and I had a Gene. Actually, Gene didn't go. That's right. Oops. But my grandkids and some other things. Family went. Yeah, my daughter went. Yeah. But let me just say this. The truth is our relationship with our other universities in our university system is strong. Strong as ever, I think. And just yesterday, we concluded the Board of Governors meeting here in Tallahassee. And then last November, I'll tell you that I joined President Fox of the University of Florida, President Hitt of the University of Central Florida, President Genshaf from the President of South Florida. And we went to Washington to do one thing, and that was to promote to national reporters and share the good news about higher education in the state of Florida. And there's a lot of good news there. Last spring, U.S. News and World Report named Florida the best state for higher education in the nation. And that's a testimony to a lot of things. Great faculty, great students, the legislature empowering our universities to rise to excellent levels. Florida was ranked above the other 49 states because of, you know, top graduation rates, low debt at graduation, and relatively low tuition rates. In fact, after financial aid, this is a good, interesting fact, the average cost of earning a bachelor's degree in Florida is less than $15,000. Now, that's a lot of money, I grant you, but compared to other states, we are a great bargain for the quality of education that our students are getting in the state of Florida. So it's a great value, and all the schools have shown improvement on the metrics and are reflected in the national rankings, but none, and I underline none, Dave Micah and others, none have shown greater progress than Florida State University. In September, it was last year, U.S. News and World Report ranked FSU the 33rd best public university in the country. Just 2 years ago, when I spoke to you last at Tiger Bay, we were ranked 43rd. To move up 10 slots in 2 years is an incredible leap, not because of the president, but because of the great faculty and great students and programs. But in fact, no other public university in the top 50 in America moved up more than Florida State University, so I'm very proud of that. Despite the wonderful news this past year, one of my worst days of my presidency occurred in November when I learned that one of our students had died after attending an off-campus fraternity party. Losing a member of our family, our FSU family, is always hard, but to see a young person's life cut short so senselessly was especially heartbreaking. I don't think I can express any words of the pain that Andrew Coffey's loved ones are experiencing, and I hope no other family has to suffer this kind of tragedy. That's why I called for an interim suspension of all real life activities on campus, and I think it's important that our campus take the time to reflect upon the loss of a young life while our entire university community works together to shift the campus. You met Vice President Amy Heck. She has done a marvelous job in terms of bringing all the stakeholders in, talking to them about what our values, what our expectations are, what our concerns are about this type of activity. And she's done a remarkable job, and I think at the end of the day, we will have a healthier and safer environment that surrounds all group life activities. In order for there to be real change, our students have had to be a part of that solution. And I think they have. They've stepped up to the plate. I really believe they're now beginning to understand and fully understand, if you will, the serious obligations they have to exercise responsible conduct. We expect to lift the suspension soon. But this is just the beginning of what we hope will be a real cultural shift on campus. Not the end, it's the beginning of something, but not certainly not the end. If the past is any kind of prologue, they really only need to look at our success over the past year. The university's reached new heights, and I believe achieved a level of national prominence that has never been seen before in our history. And we owe it all to our great faculty and the incredible students that are coming to this university. So I have no doubt that 2018 will begin to, I believe, to bring some challenges. They always do. Every day is a new day at Florida State and any university. Some people asked me before, how's it like being president of the university compared to the legislature? Well, I said, yes, there may be some similarities to politics. It's like being the mayor of a small town. But the difference is the constituents are 18 and 19 years old. Adds a whole new flavor. But we have some great opportunities. I just want to come here today and thank each and every one of you. I know there's some Gators here and some others, but I also know you live in Tallahassee and you care about this great university, and I appreciate that. So I thank you for that. I thank you for allowing me to be here today to talk about what I believe is one of the finest universities in America. Thank you very much.